Today we're going to take a look at how we can sum values based on a partial text match. SUMIFS is great when you are summing values based on criteria. Now, it always looks for an exact match for that criteria. But in this case, we're going to see how to handle cases where we want to look for a partial text match. Here's our sample data set. We have a list of company IDs, customer IDs, and quantities sold. Now, what we want to do is to sum the quantity which contains these company IDs, right? So you can see here we have a partial match. Any company ID that has AT in it, we want their quantity to be summed, and we want to see it here. So I'm going to use the SUMIFS formula. First argument in the SUMIFS is the sum range. What do I want to sum? The quantity. So I'm just going to highlight that, control shift down to jump to the bottom. I'm going to fix the area here using the F4 key because I am planning to pull down my formula and I don't want this reference to shift. Next argument is criteria range 1. That's the range where my first criteria is sitting on. What's my actual criteria? Is this. Where is the range it's sitting on? It's this. So that's what I need here. Control shift down, press F4 to fix. Now, my criteria I said is this, but it's not exactly this, right? Because if I close the bracket here, I get 0. It's looking for an exact match. It's looking for 80 in here. It's not finding it. It's giving me a 0. So here comes the use of wildcards. And one handy wildcard here is the asterisk sign or this multiplication sign. So this is the sign that I need to put either before or after this. And in this case, since I want AT to fall anywhere in this text, it could be at the beginning, could be in the middle, could be in the end, it doesn't matter. I'm going to put this on both sides, so before and after. Now notice because I'm putting it in my formula, I need to put it inside quotation marks. It's seen as text in there. And if I press enter right now, I can't leave the formula because I need the and sign. So whenever you're combining text with cell reference, you need to add the and sign. And right after the AT, I'm also going to add that asterisk sign because this would mean that my AT could fall anywhere. Now when I press enter, I'm going to push this down. I'm going to get the sum of quantities for wherever I have these fields in there. Okay, so next part, we're just going to restrict this a little bit. We actually want the 10 to be in the first two characters right here. Now I'm just going to copy this formula and paste it here so I don't have to rewrite everything. What do I need to update in this formula to make it work? I have to take away the asterisk sign from the beginning, right? So from before the 10, because I want it to start with 10, and after that, it could be anything, right? So don't forget the asterisk means any type of text or number, any length, it doesn't matter. Whatever comes after this doesn't matter. Okay, it's taken into account. Okay, so now let's think about how to update this formula to sum values for quantity where the last two characters are 10. So what do we need to change now here? We need to take away the asterisk sign from the end, right? So this means it ends with 10. Everything before doesn't matter. It's included in our sum. Now, the next one is something different. We want to sum the quantity only where the fifth and the sixth character is a 10. How do we do this one? Let me just copy and paste this one here again, and let's see how we can update this. This part is something I need to change because I want to make sure that only four characters come before this 10 here. And that means I need to use the question mark. So the difference between the question mark and the asterisk sign is that the question mark is a fixed placeholder. So if you use it once, it means it replaces one text, one character basically, of your text with anything, right? It could be a number, it could be a symbol, it could be anything. If you use it twice, it means it's placeholder for two characters. So in this case, we're going to use it four times, and then we want our 10 to appear. And then after that, we can leave the asterisk sign if anything else could appear after the 10. Okay, so that's 520. That's just this case here. That's how you can use this combination of wildcard characters to get the outcome that you want. Now, the next one is actually a question that was raised in the comments of one of the previous SUMIFS videos. And someone asked that they have the problem where the first two characters and the last two characters are basically given in the cells, and then they need to sum values based on this, right? So first two characters should be 80, last two in this case should be 30, only those values should be summed, and similar for the other ones. Okay, so here, let's just write this one from scratch. First comes our sum range, which was this. I'm gonna fix it. Next comes criteria range one, which was this one. Let's fix it. Now comes the criteria. Okay, so it's not exactly this, right? We want to make sure that the first two characters is 80 and the last two characters is 30. So here what comes handy is the left and the right functions. So let's use the left function, and we're going to strip out the first two characters, right? So those should be 80. Then after this, we could have any variable sized text in there, put the asterisk sign. Then I'm going to use the right function and strip out the last two characters of this. 1620, so that adds on this here and here and here, 1620. Okay, so we can just push that down. The reason I'm using actually SUMIFS here is that it's really easy to update the moment more criteria come in, because it's very likely that your boss could come in and be like, well, could you also add a second criteria? Could you also add in the customer here? Now, all I have to do, let's just copy my SUMIFS here. Let's just check the referencing. That should reference this one, right? So that takes me back to what I had here. Now, all I have to do is to add in the customer. I'm just going to add extra arguments here. So where is this customer sitting in? It's sitting right here. Again, don't forget the fixing. The actual criteria is right here. So that was a quick update of adding an additional criteria to our original sum formula. Okay, so that's how you can use SUMIFS and wildcards to look for partial text matches. If you enjoyed this video, if you learned something new, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you like this type of videos, if you want to become more advanced in Excel, do consider subscribing to this channel.